this movie's badass. Love it. Oh, hey, Sean. Welcome to Ottawa's Ultimate Theater. We had an idea a while ago for a video for the tech chat, for us to build this ultimate theater, have the techs come in, do a movie night, you know, just have a good time and really just kind of like push the limits, stuff that we don't normally do, you know, like 7.1 mixing and cool stuff like that. But with Customer Service Week coming up and some new techs here in Ottawa, we thought what we'd do is we'd incorporate it into rigging and lighting training. And you know, they're getting obviously some other stuff, audio and video, which I think is really cool. I think they had an awesome time, I had an awesome time, and next week when we do our movie nights, I think everyone's really going to enjoy and appreciate what we accomplished here. So I know you're looking around, you're like, well, it's, you know, nothing crazy here. You got some drape, got some speakers and a screen, but it's much more than what you see, because it's a full 7.1 surround sound, dialed in theater. We went with the Meyer system. You know, we toyed around with, oh, maybe we should use Rankus and do a bunch of Rankus stacks, which would have been pretty cool. But it was kind of an availability thing. And to be honest, Meyer's badass. Sounds awesome. So what we did for our sub channel, we just paired up a couple to set of 650 subs here. Center channel, CQ1. Our front left, we've got a CQ1. And our front right, we did a CQ1. For our surround channels, we doubled up the UPAs. And we've got those great little UPA CQ1 plates, which give you that nice splay that you're supposed to have. So it does a really good job for surround channels because it's like a super wide image. So when we were watching stuff earlier, like it's like huge presence coming from the surround channels. So this part's really cool. We have these, two of these in our inventory, and I've yet to find a use except for this theater build. So it's a HDMI in pass-through, but it rips the linear PCM audio tracks off of the HDMI. So we're running Blu-ray, it's from a PS3, but it does the PCM thing very well. I know you're probably all like, oh, it's so old, get a PS4. Trust me, the PS3 does a really good job for choosing what sort of audio tracks you want to use. So come off of the box with the minis into PCDIs. We did it this way just because we didn't have enough of the mini to XLRs. It's fine, it works out great. We've broken up each individual track, front left, front right, sub, center, blah, 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 all the way across the console, and then sent each one of those to its own individual bus. So when it comes to flattening, we could use the graphic EQs on the Soundcraft to flatten each one of the channels. We're trying to give THX a run for its money here. So we went all Meyer. I don't think Soundcraft really falls into that category. Projection end, we didn't use DLPs because they weren't available, thanks Montreal, but we went with the 10K LCDs. We got them doubled up, Sean doubled them up really fast, and it's, when the lights are off in the warehouse, it looks badass, like no complaints, especially with this kind of content. Yeah, if we had IMAG, I'm sure people would be complaining, but it looks awesome, it does a really good job, especially with the video games, it's really fast refresh rates and stuff, so. Any movies we're playing, we're going straight from the PlayStation. We're splitting it with an HDMI splitter. One cable goes into the Atlona box to spread out the audio. The other two go up to our double converged Christie projectors to do the image, and that's it. No other processing, just because we were concerned about latency issues or delays in the video. I'm sure video guys all over are freaking out right now, but that was our train of thought. So this is what we did. You can do your own theater. Let's talk about lighting. So because we were doing training, I know this is branch level training. We've already done the basics, but you know, we had the new guys here, and because we wanted to do a rigging lighting thing, I thought let's kind of give them a real world scenario. Let's get some LEDs in the space, light up some drape. 250s are obviously because I like lighting, so we had added some Mac 250s. We did like full individual channels for all the LEDs. We showed them how to uplight drape, even downlight drape from the top, which is pretty cool. We did some auras up in the space. Just honestly, we didn't want to do any conventionals. It's just power-wise, it was difficult. And I find like more and more with the lighting rigs we're doing, we're kind of starting to move away from the conventionals and go towards more moving heads and LEDs. So, you know, I thought it was a really cool experience for the new guys to see how this stuff gets set up, to learn how to do all the cable runs. So that's why we did all of this fancy lighting in this build. And it looks pretty cool. You know, when we get to some lightsaber fights, maybe I'll get the 250 swinging around and everyone will be mad at me and I'll blind them in the face, put it up on screen. Because that's what us lighting guys do. You know, we talked about the space, but obviously you got to be comfortable when you're watching a movie. This is pretty hilarious. The only comfortable furniture we had were these office chairs. They were all on casters and we tried to pull them off, but it didn't work. So we ended up just doing some tiered seating and using ratchet straps to strap in our chairs. So if you're up here, you can't really roll off, but it's pretty comfortable. So yeah, that's the theater. Our plan. This week we're going to have all the staff in, we're going to watch Star Wars, we're going to watch Mad Max, and we're going to play some video games. And this is where things get really fun, because Sean Watson, who's behind the camera, say hi.
Hi.
Hi. Has brought in Nintendo 64, Super Nintendo, Wii U, so we're going to play Mario Kart, Star Fox, Super Smash Bros. So yeah, this is the theater build. Hope you enjoyed our video.